Jane Goff, UNICEF's Regional Director voor Latijns-Amerika en het Caribisch gebied, heeft haar opwachting gemaakt bij president Chandrika Prasad Santokhi. Tijdens de ontmoeting op het kabinet van de president heeft men zich gebogen over kinderrechten zoals onderwijs en sociale veiligheid. De Regional Director is blij dat onderwijs een belangrijke plaats heeft in het meerjaren ontwikkelingsplan.
We just had a very interesting meeting with the, Mr. President. And we were pleased to discuss with him. And I congratulated him for the finalization of their National Development Plan 2022-2006. And UNICEF also, we just got approved in our executive board in February, our development plan and our country program document that also goes 2022-2026. So it was a great opportunity for us to see where these plans complement each other. And as I said, UNICEF is here in this country to support the development of children's rights in the country and making sure that we don't leave no one behind. We talked about reopening of schools, and I was very pleased to learn and congratulated the government for reopening of schools, because we know that the pandemic due to COVID had affected not so much children from the health perspective, but the children was more affected because they were robbed from their schools. Schools has been closed for a long time. That has a lot of consequences on their mental health. And we also discussed about the mental health and the First Lady involvement in making sure that we have programs that looks at the mental health of kids. Because schools are not only a place of learning, they're places where children learn how to interact with other kids. In some schools, they get their only meal of the day is given in schools. So from UNICEF, we do believe the schools are a place that needs to be reopened as soon as possible. He was also concerned about the flooding that's happening in the hinterlands. And I think this is an area that we promised to come back in and really go and understand what's the magnitude of the problem and how we could help in getting these schools back up and running. We also talked about the use of technology in schools, because that's another lesson that we learned from the COVID pandemic, that the education system was not prepared for being in a remote mode or a hybrid mode. We believe in UNICEF that children need a teacher, but we also believe that technology has a role to play in improving the quality of learning. So we also discussed how we could continue improving and ensuring that technology is available in each school and the teacher has a tool to help improve quality of learning. We also talked about water and sanitation, because we do believe that the schools, hospitals, communities, we need to have water of high quality, we need to have sanitation services. So those were discussions that we looked at. He was also discussing about the difficulties due to the when he took over government of the debt, but he is confident that now there is some more space in the budget to look at social safety net programs and how UNICEF could also support in this process of social safety net. So I think it was a very interesting discussion on areas of mutual interest. We talked about violence, because violence against children is one of the things that we see across countries in Latin America and the Caribbean. And we believe that if we want to reduce violence, we need to start in homes, we need to start in schools, and we need to start in the communities. So we agreed to continue working to identify signs where we could work together and look at the barriers from the legal perspective, that we could eliminate corporate punishment in different spaces, and really work with communities, religious leaders, to make sure that we reduce violence in school. I talked about education, that's a number one. We talked about the social child protection areas, and here we are looking at how we make sure that the legal reforms are in place. Violence against children is another big priority, and we will also be looking at COVID has also, we want to look at accelerate the services for children, because maybe the vaccination was people did not go to the health centers. So we really need to go back and look at data, look and make sure that we recover if children has not been getting their full vaccination, so we have the reduction of preventable diseases. So I think these are things that we will continue to work here in Suriname together with the government and make sure that we continue to protect children. Mental health, of course, is one of the big consequences of the pandemic, and we will allow to do more because I think we need, children deserves better.